So the first and foremost thing that we are going to start with is making our own homemade buttermilk. For which here I am weighing out 1.5 cups of warm milk. To that I'll be adding 1.5 teaspoon of vinegar. Give it a mix and let it sit for 5 minutes. The next thing to do is preheat your waffle maker just by switching it on. Coming to our dry ingredients for the waffle batter, we will weigh out 1.5 cups of all-purpose flour, that is maida, 1/2 cup of cocoa powder. This is premium dark quality one. You can use anything that is available to you. To that we will add in 1/4 cup of corn flour. Teaspoon of baking powder, a teaspoon of baking soda, and a pinch of salt. Just sift them together until it's all combined and the cocoa powder is all lump free. Add in 1/2 cup of sugar and give everything a mix. So that was our dry ingredients. By now the buttermilk would have been curdled and ready. To that we will add in 1/2 cup of milk, 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence, and mix everything. Finally add in 4 tablespoons of oil and 2 tablespoons of melted butter. If you are wondering why we are using 2 kinds of milk, that is buttermilk and milk, and again 2 kinds of fats, that is oil and butter, in one single recipe, then definitely check out my blog post on spicesandflavors.com for a detailed and why, how, everything that you need to know. So finally combine the wet and dry ingredients and you have your beautiful aromatic chocolate waffles batter all ready. Just look how thin the batter is, and that is exactly how you want it to be. By this time the waffle heater would be preheated, that is the indication of the red light turning green is shows you that it's all ready. Even though it's a non-stick coating, but I always like to brush it with some melted butter before I actually pour in the chocolate waffle batter, just to be on the safe side that it doesn't stick. So for my waffle maker, 1/2 cup of batter is just perfect to make the waffles. I would say the first set is always a suicidal waffle, that's how I like to call it. That is because each waffle maker is different, so you will have to test the first one to see how much batter is needed and how much minutes you need to cook the chocolate waffles in your particular waffle maker. So in mine, I'm adding 1/2 cup and will keep it for 4 minutes. See how steam is escaping out, and by the time the waffle is cooked, there's no steam at all, just like the way you can see it here in the video. And just in a matter of 4 minutes, you have your beautiful chocolate waffle all ready to be dived in. So it's tender, light and fluffy in the center and crispy and crunchy in the outside, just like the way how it is supposed to be. Serve your waffles warm with a dollop of whipped cream on top, some strawberries, blueberries or any kind of berries, and a drizzle of chocolate sauce. You have an amazing breakfast all set. Since I have added just 1/2 cup of sugar onto our waffle batter, so this is perfect enough for a breakfast because there is no sweetness on the waffle itself. We are just making it sweet with the addition of cream and berries. But if you like to serve it for dessert, then definitely increase the quantity of sugar from 1/2 cup to 3/4 cup. Another way of serving this is by adding some passion fruit and mango compote that was left over from my fruit cake recipe video. It is totally affordable and so cheap to make your own chocolate waffles at home as compared to the Belgian Waffle Company or any other cafes or supermarkets that serve waffles. You must definitely invest in a waffle maker if you like having waffles. I have linked few in the description box below for your convenience. Just check it out if you wish to. To store the waffles, just individually wrap each one using a cling wrap and then place it in a Ziploc bag and store it in your freezer and use it as and when needed. And when you need them, just take it out of the cling wrap, place it on a baking tray that has been lined with a parchment paper, and then put it in a preheated oven of 160 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. That would not only warm it up but also crispen it up. Perfect, right? Definitely check out the blog post if you would like to know how to serve these chocolate waffles just like the Belgium style waffle company. And also there are details that if you would like to make it for a party or for a crowd, then how can you make it in bulk, store and reheat just like the way I have shown it in the video, but much more in depth on the blog post. So that was it for today's video, and if you liked it, definitely hit that like button. Subscribe to Spices and Flavors for more such desserts and baking related recipes. I'll see you soon in my next one. Until then, this is Sushma signing off. Take care. Bye bye.